Bulblax Kingdom, sub-level 1. I've never done this before, actually. Gotten a new color of Pikmin and then immediately headed into a cave with that Pikmin. And I'm scared, to be honest. Especially considering that it's this area. The Bulblax Kingdom is all about Bulborbs because they're part of the Bulblax species. And they introduce a new kind of Bulborb that I don't like. It's scary. But first, we'll take care of these dwarves. Okay. Nice. Come on. It's kind of interesting, whenever I kill a Bulborb, a dwarf Bulborb, oh boy. A dwarf Bulborb with a purple Pikmin, there's actually an animation where it rides the Bulborb until it's dead. So you can't actually grab it. So in a group of Bulborbs, it's kind of dangerous. Okay, but this is the orange Bulborb. Unlike normal Bulborbs, this one isn't fully asleep. If I get close, it will wake up. So I can't easily position behind it and then prepare for a rear rush strategy. I just have to come at it. I can try to get behind it, but it's going to be kind of difficult because right now I'm skirting the edge of its range. Also, this one's carrying a treasure, so I need to kill it. I need to remember I have Ultra Bitter Sprays. Okay, there we go. Got our reds on it. Don't kill anything, please. Nice. Okay. Throw some reds in here. Cool. And carry both of them back. As quickly as possible. There's another Bulborb I need to grab. But he's a little bit off the beaten path. In fact, I'm not even sure if he's carrying anything. I guess we'll find out. Also, we got white Pikmin, which I hadn't taken in here, which makes me wonder if there's poison. I don't think there, if I recall, there's no poison in here. So I don't know why they gave us white Pikmin. Oh, I know why. Oh, I'm dumb. Oh, I'm so glad they gave me that. Something's buried. That's why. Something must be buried in this cave, so I need white Pikmin. Crystal Clover. Wait, okay, nothing's buried in this one. Huh. Also, I just realized I've never demonstrated the new move we got when we got white Pikmin. I mean, I demonstrated it once, but I haven't used it yet. The carry back to base thing. Do I want to kill this guy just for funsies? No, I'm going to let him live. We're essentially going into a den of Bulborbs, so I don't need to kill everyone around. I mean, this is kind of their home. I'm not here for them. I'm here for the treasure that they are keeping around that they don't need and apparently decide to eat. Because whenever you see a clover made of emeralds, the first thing you want to do is eat it. The Dumbos. Oh, that is a new enemy. And in fact, this is the first antagonist of the game. You didn't think that Pikmin had an antagonist, but let me tell you right now, it does. There he is. That's a fiery Dweevil. Dweevils will be interesting, or not interesting, they'll be important later on. Let me see if I can show this off, because fiery Dweevils aren't that bad. They kind of mind their own business, unless you attack them, and in which case they will do, if I can, come on, buddy. Come on. Show it off. Show it off. You're dying here, buddy. Come on. There you go. They're elemental, which means that they, well, do I really need to explain what elemental means? They're elemental, so there are different ones in different elements that have different attacks, but they're all pretty much the same pattern of attack. They just ignite the area around them in fire or poison or electricity. But they're interesting for this reason. Watch this guy. Watch him. Watch him. He sees a treasure. And then he picks it up. He doesn't care about it. He just wants to carry it around. These guys are hoarders. And they use it almost as armor. They'll even carry around dead bodies, carcasses, including the carcasses of their kin, which looks hilarious, actually, when you see... Wait, who's attacking? Oh, hello. When you see a dweevil carrying another dweevil, so it looks like it has eight legs. It's kind of hilarious, and the legs are sticking up in the air. Tearstone. That's much prettier than the heartstone, or the petrified heart we got earlier. Okay, so that's the last treasure. This cave is just kind of introducing dweevils to the arsenal of enemies. These guys only appear underground. Just like normal spiders, they appear in dark areas, and... But these ones are hoarders. A lot of interesting enemies in Pikmin. And you could... It's kind of world-building as well, especially when you consider the Piklopedia. And honestly, the Piklopedia is a good read. If you take the time to go in and look at Olimar's commentary on the different enemies, you learn things. And they really did a lot of world-building in the Piklopedia, but because it's not required, you never pick up on it. They talk about how different species have adapted. Oh, hello. So many new enemies! I love this cave. The Withering Blowhog. Now, these guys don't kill Pikmin, but they're not good either. That doesn't mean that they're harmless. They will deflower Pikmin, actually, if they're able to blow on the Pikmin. They're also balloons, which is kind of a cute touch. I have no clue what these guys would have been derived from. Oh, well, there are some Pikmin that are now without flowers. I believe for these guys it takes 10 Pikmin to bring it to the ground, which means a single purple will bring it to the ground and allow me to swarm them. Whoa, who are you attacking? Oh, okay, that's cool. Please don't exit my sight, children. Pikmin are children, everyone. They behave just like children. They follow around the leader. They emulate the leader. Oh, this is why they gave me yellow or white Pikmin. Yeah, you guys get on that. Oh, wait, come on. I have more white Pikmin than that. Get on this. There you go. Let me take some reds because I think I saw a ivory candy pot butt. There it is. I knew I saw it. I just didn't pay much attention to it. Okay, come here. Well, that happens. Actually, wait. What'd you grab? I need to see that. What is it? What'd you grab? Oh, good job. You got a snail shell. Oh, good job, everyone. I love how white Pikmin in particular, and they will do this of their... Sorry, excuse me. I'm still not entirely well. They'll do this of their own accord as well. If they see a treasure, even if you're not using the C-stick, they will just lock onto it and just randomly start digging. That's what happened when we first got white Pikmin. They just see something and they're like, hey, look guys, I found it. It's like, what did you find? A snail shell. Oh, good job, honey. You found it. Good job. Good job, everyone. I just love them. They have so much character. Especially when, I mean, this is kind of mean. I love it when you're just walking around and they trip. And it's completely random. There's nothing for them to trip on. They just fall down. They'll do other random things, like sing. Oh, I interrupted their singing. I'm sorry. See, they're trying to make beautiful music. Aw. They're just like children. Oh, this is actually pretty useful. Oh, of course. Well, of course, one or two of them hogged all of the nectar. Okay, have I explored all of this cave? I feel like I haven't. No, I guess I have. Okay. There aren't that many treasures on each floor, but maybe there are a lot of floors. I don't know. Delve deeper? Yeah. Delve is a good mechanic. I mean, it's kind of broken, but delving is good, kind of. Magic the Gathering reference for anyone who cares. Delve was a very unbalanced mechanic. If it was good, it was too good. If it was bad, then, I mean, it was just kind of forgotten. Oh, boy. Oh, these. Oh. Okay. So these will instantly kill Pikmin. Wait, oh. Did I really throw a red? Ah, my. I shouldn't have laughed at that red Pikmin's death. But I was just going to say, you're never going to see the animation of them dying to the lightning, because I will be very careful not to do that. And then I messed it up. So, these things are nasty. On that note, good job, pal. You are a good scholar. The bad thing about those is that they're blocking off the path. Unlike the fiery geysers, where maybe a Pikmin will walk over the top of it, these things block a path. So if I don't take care of one of... Oh, hello. Oh, there's a treasure in here. Got the treasure, and it's gone. Okay. So if I don't take care of all of these arc things, I don't even know what they're called. I don't even think they have an entry in the Piklopedia. If I don't take care of all of these, then a Pikmin, there's a good chance that one of these Pikmin will be carrying a treasure along a path. That path will happen to take them along the route of one of those, and it will just kill all the Pikmin carrying a treasure. And then they're just gone. So I need to be very careful to clear off the paths before I let Pikmin start carrying a goodie. Okay. This cave is kind of interestingly laid out. It's like a hybrid between one of the first floors we had white Pikmin on and the floor that we got purple Pikmin on. Oh, hello. These are anode beetles. Now, on their own... Oh, okay. On their own, they're harmless, actually. But if there are multiples, if there's at least two, then they can cause serious damage to the group. Crystal King. A lot of crystals we're getting. They can cause serious damage to the troop. The only way to defeat them is to throw a single Pikmin on top of them, and then swarm them while they're down. And then they're easy pickings. But the thing is if there are more than two of them, they'll do that. So they're basically like the arky things, but mobile. I used to as... Oh, no! Ah! More new enemies! Why are there so many? Ah, that is a Wallywog! Get off the life of me. You. Yeah, kill him. Die, Wallywog. That is a normal Wallywog, actually. All the other ones we've seen thus far are yellow Wallywogs. That one is a regular one, which means that they came from caves first. Kind of odd. Unknown merit. That's... Oh, that makes sense. It's a Chinese coin? Is it a Chinese coin? It may be some other Asian coin, but... Yeah, unknown merit, because it's probably a discontinued currency, or just because it's a frozen game. Hello. Lagging game. Hello, game? Are you good? You need a snack? No, okay. Why am I lagging? This is odd. But as I was saying, because I get so many interruptions, I used to call these guys love bugs, because they need another anode beetle to do anything, which kind of makes sense, because then, like, this guy doesn't do anything. He won't hurt you. He won't hurt you at all, but they need someone else to connect with, so it's... You know what? I'm just going to call them eHarmony bugs from now on, because they connect via electricity, and they can't function without anyone else, so... eHarmony bugs that it is. It's not a catchy name, but it's an apt one. Sublevel 5, Bulblax Kingdom. Are we getting close to the last floor? I have not looked up how many Oh. Oh. This is the music. This is why the cave is my favorite. This music's so good. I love it. I have listened to this on loop for so many hours in my life. It just gets me, it gets me going. Like, it's kind of upbeat, but it's also a song that kind of, that fills you with like determination because you feel like you're supposed to be doing something. I love it. Ah! I can't scream because I'm still slightly sick. Of all the things that could drop from the sky, it was a harmless thing, but it scared me. The purple drop you see contains refined ultra bitter essence. One drop contains one dose. Use it on hostile creatures. Approach the creatures and press up on the D-pad to spray. I got scared half to death by Kool-Aid. Purple Kool-Aid. Ah, no! Run! No! Ah! Why are things falling from the sky? Stop it! And I lost a white Pikmin from that. But I'm gonna play it where it lies. Even though it'd be really easy, actually, for me to just quit and restart at this floor and do that. But no, I'm playing it where it lies. Those Pikmin are dead. They're gone for good. So now I know what to watch out for. This floor is introducing death and scares. Yeah, anxious sprout. Yeah, is anxious because there's a bomb hanging over it. You dumb. Where am I going? Were there enemies? Why are there enemies this way? But no treasure, no loot. You know what? I'm scared. Let's leave them there. I'm just gonna kind of walk around, see if I can trigger anything. Come here. Come on. I want to see what was over here. This! A bomb rock! It's gonna kill this Bulborb, and maybe me? Yeah, it killed- well, it barely hurt me. Okay. Man, that hurt him, for sure. Let's brush this plant. Another bomb rock! Get over here! Get over here. Yeah! You- get a taste of your own medicine! Stupid bomb rock killed a white Pikmin, and a blue, I think. I mean, no purples died, but I'm pretty sure that killed a blue. So, that's not good. Let's go to the next floor. Yeah, things can drop from the sky, and they can be nectar or a spray, as was displayed, or they could be death. Which is why I didn't react immediately when I saw something fall. I'm like, oh, it's another spray, but no, they trick you. They trick you by giving you something good, and then they take it away. Why am I lagging? This is HD, but my computer can handle this. Okay. What's in store? A dwarf orange Bulborb, more lag. I'm gonna love this in editing. And... in fact, you know what? Actually, I can do something to fix the lag. Give me a moment. There, I just deleted every single recording of the Overwatch and League videos, so that freed up some space, so the lag is actually gone. Okay, that worked. 60 gigs was enough to make it work. Normally I don't break the fourth wall like that, but it was causing some serious not fun times. Okay, now I need to know to be careful of death from the sky places. Sky places are death, apparently. If only I had winged Pikmin scout. No, get over here. Let's go this way. Because this way probably has death. Leads over there. This probably has death. No, it has nectar. Okay. I mean, it's a gift. It's probably going to be giving me something deathy soon, but I'll be wary. I have flower Pikmin, so I can run away from the death. I'm gonna take the path less traveled. Get over here, purple Pikmin. You're so slow. Alright. So, there's a fiery Dweevil. There's an orange Bulborb, which I would have been able to sneak up. Oh, there's multiple. There are multiple. Alright, let's take care of the Dweevil first, because he's going to be kind of an interesting hazard because he's so mobile. You can die. You can also die. I'll add to the fray by punching. I never talk about that. I can punch, guy. Oh, don't look at me. You see that? He's looking. He's looking at me. They're creepy. Because you know they're watching. They're kind of asleep. Or they may not even be asleep, actually. They could just be actually watching. Oh, hello. You're a skull. A human. Run! Well, thank you for being useful, at least. They are watching! Stop! I feel like I'm a child. Which, I guess the Pikmin are rubbing off on me, because I'm a child asking a big thing to stop looking at me. Okay, we're gonna be using our bitter spray now. I have not used it yet. So, walk up. There we go. And cutscene. Which immediately wastes the spray, unless they extend the timer on it. Most impressive! This fierce beast became as hard as stone in a mere instant. The ultra bitter extract seems to have a side effect that stops beasts in their track. Yeah. Bro. Come on. Yes! Killed him. Whoa. Be careful with that. You don't know where that's been. Oh, that's dumb. You see the fiery geyser? I can't actually get at that. No, I can't even get at it. Okay, well, different strat. Throw all my Pikmin here. Drop them. No, you guys get over here. I just want the reds for this. No, stop. Go. No. Stop it. Okay. Use my bitter spray on him. Ready, set, go. And kill him, make him spray, yeah. And we got another bitter spray. Kill him too? I guess not. But I got another bitter spray out of that, which is neat. So effectively I didn't use one. So whenever I kill an enemy that has that is solidified, it can drop spray, it could drop nectar. In fact, if I kill a boss that way, sometimes they drop an insane amount of loot. Come on, kill him. Watch out for the fire, because that hurts Olimar, but not these Pikmin. And he's dead. All right, clear out the rest of these hazards, like this one. And I'll grab the... They're giving me a lot of Crimson Candy Pop Buds, which, I mean... Oh, hello. Mitites, I believe. I'll kill some of them. No! I mean, that guy, for some reason, decided to kill himself. That was not my fault. I'm losing Pikmin left and right now. That was not my fault. You saw that. I whistled him, and he still died. So, some things you can't help. This cave is mean. I mean, I love the music, but it's a mean cave. I mean, they're giving me so many things. You see the combo there. You think there's treasure? You walk here. The Mitites come up, scare all of the Pikmin, a bomb rock drops, and then all of them are dead. That is so, so nasty. Okay, is this the only treasure here? I think it is. I'll scout around. Oh, I forgot. The skull. I'll tackle the skull. But I think those are the only two treasures here. I want to make sure that it moves quickly as well, because if a bomb rock drops, all bets are off. Also, this takes 20. I'll put way more than that. Like I said, I'm paranoid of bomb rocks now because they've killed quite a few Pikmin so far. And it looks like no others will drop. Neat. Was there anything over here? Or did we walk? We walked that way. Okay. So this is all of the treasures on this floor. We'll get these out of the way. Then we'll go further down. I think we're towards the end of the cave. It's been actually kind of tough. Oh, it's gold and pretty. Eternal Emerald Eye. And the skull. Once again, proof that this is Earth, at the very least, because what else would look like this? This is actually, well, this isn't a human skull. This is an ape or monkey skull. So, or actually, it could be something else. I guess the eye structure is wrong for it to be anything else. I was like, it could be kind of, it looks like there's a muzzle, so there could, it could be a dog, but no, that doesn't work. Okay, so that's the last treasure. We'll grab our purple and leave. That guy's dead. Yeah, he is. How many Pikmin do we go in here with? 90-something? 80? I think we went in with 84, and we're down to 75. So, caves will do that. I'm not trying to do a zero-death run, though that is possible. I'm just trying to reduce casualties as best I can. Is this the boss? Oh, this is the boss. Okay. I love how useful the blues have been. A lot of sarcasm in that. Aww. Holy moly. Okay. So this is an enemy that we've seen before. If you've watched my Pikmin 1 Let's Play, you know what this is. Let's circle around behind. Okay, that's a black gate. I won't bother with that right now. Also, actually, no, the blues will be useful. Yeah, they'll be pretty useful. There's water over there. Okay, well, I'm glad I brought them. This is the final boss of Pikmin 1. Last we saw this, it was in the final trial, and it held the piggy bank. I forgot what it's called. And now we're facing it here. I'm really nervous about this. I'm expecting deaths. But let's approach it. Aww. Hey, buddy. That's the Emperor Bulblax. Is he bigger? He's bigger than he was in Pikmin 1. Aww. And this time we don't have bomb rocks. Can I? Yes, I can. Okay, come on. Oh, that does nothing. Come on. Come on. No. He missed. Get out of the way. That's a one yellow. So, the dangerous thing about him is he's slow, but he has the capability of eating all of my Pikmin in a single swipe of that tongue. In fact, if I can, I would like to reduce my numbers here. There. Yeah. 31 is a good size for a unit if I'm fighting a boss. No. I need to be careful. Okay, now I can punish the ending lag. Whoa, no! He's almost dead. I lost a ton of reds there. Oh. Yes. And he's dead. Wow. I've lost so many Pikmin in this cave. But, I mean, I got through it. Hey. My initial report indicates that the giant Bulblax spat out some sort of object. It looks fascinating, but it's drenched in that creature's internal juices. Disgusting. Oh, don't roll your eyes at me. I'll store it for you. Okay. I'm kind of glad that I have as many Pikmin as I do. I have actually completed caves and beaten the bosses, only to lack the amount of Pikmin. In fact, I did this with the final boss of this game. I beat him, and then I lacked the Pikmin required to actually get all of the treasures that he dropped. and it was terrible. It was a terrible feeling to just see everything sitting there and know that when I went back, he'd be back. And he'd have all the treasures inside him. Yeah. Well, we got the Forged Courage, which is yet another upgrade. This material has perplexing properties. I will try fusing it with the with this spare spacesuit. Processing complete. Success. Behold my latest invention, the Scorch Guard. Thanks to the heat-resistant alloy, this suit is now impervious to fire. Have I ever gotten hurt by fire? I don't think I have. So, I mean, cool, I'm invincible to fire, but meh. I mean, okay, I won't knock it. It's not bad. It's just, as far as upgrades go, it's not the best, but it's not bad. I mean, if you're good at the game, you're not taking damage. But I understand that sometimes damage will happen. So an immunity to fire is not the worst thing. All right. So there's fire here. How will I deal with this? Oh, I know how. Red Pikmin, go up there. Do I have enough? I don't know. Do I actually have enough? I may not. It's kind of interesting that they left a treasure after the boss. Especially since on this, it's on a shrine. It's actually on a shrine. It's kind of odd for a, you know, a treasure, but it's on a shrine. And this treasure actually has some significance. This is what, well, this is based on the same thing. Oh, I have barely enough. I have exactly enough, okay. This is based on the same thing that gyro, like the gyroids in Animal Crossing are based off of. I don't believe this is Dogu, though it may be. Is this Dogu? You know, I could look it up, or I could let the comment section answer. Or, you know what, Future Pal, you haven't been doing anything recently. It's not like you would need to edit these episodes beyond the really awesome end slates. You, tell me what this is based on. There, thank you. You're a gentleman and a scholar. So, yeah, it's there, and it's the last treasure. And it's on a pedestal. Okay, so we got through that pretty well. And now, once we go back up, that'll be the end of the day, since it was just before the countdown from 10 that I entered the cave. So I'll try to get maybe a couple more Peliposies for the blues. Although their onion's really far away. I could try. I could see what I can do. Alright, got this treasure. It's kind of creepy looking. Gyroid bust. It's actually quite horrifying. But that means that we are 46% done with the... Or 40%... 46% of the debt is complete, which is sad, but I mean, it has to happen. In fact, there aren't that many caves left in the Awakening Wood. Actually, there's one. There's one cave left in the Awakening Wood. That's actually kind of sad. All right, treasure salvaged a lot. 1,284. I lost 18 Pikmin to get these treasures. Some of those were blues. One of them was a white. And that's the cost to get all of these treasures. Yet another cave looted. This one kind of out of order, as I said before. I mean, and also it was a very ambitious day. I've never done that before where I've gotten a color Pikmin. And then the next day I got a new color of Pikmin and immediately entered a cave with that Pikmin. And also didn't really use blues because there's no water in there. So, that's new. I'm not sure how well it actually worked out. Okay, you know what? Yellows. Could you be useful? Yeah, they can be useful. Let's go grab the Carmex container. That, I think I have just enough time to do that. Hopefully. Okay, go up there. Grab that. Good job. Man, they're fast. Except I slowed them down. No, come on, come on, come on. You can do it. You can do it. Can they do it? I'm not sure if they can do it. Unless, no, I don't wanna, I don't, that's too much time. Can they do it? They could bring it closer, I guess. Yeah, they won't make it. Or they might. Will they do it? No, they won't. Oh, they will. Oh, they will. Come on, come on. Go, 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 go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Grab it. Grab it. At the bell, at the ringer, at the buzzer. They did it. Good job. Carmex. For cold sores and other things as well. Healing cask. Those Carmex is actually really great stuff. Helps everything. Awesome. At the zero, they did it. Good job, everyone. This is probably the most productive day we've done thus far. We completed a cave, got a new color of Pikmin, and built that color up, and got 40% towards the debt being completed. And there's only one last cave left in Awakening Wood. And we're going to be saving that for later, because I would like to return here, because there are other things to do. I'd also like the cave that's left is quite difficult, and I need a substantially higher population of Pikmin in order to tackle that. Wow. Look at our Pikmin numbers. We lost 40. That's a false number. We didn't lose 40 reds because while we did lose some of those to battle, yeah, we lost 18. But we also lost some of them in the conversion to purple Pikmin. So that's kind of a skewed statistic. We lost 18 though. That hurts. That really hurts. One of them to electricity because I threw him into electricity. that was bad. I just took a call from my loan agent. He has the scariest voice I've ever heard. While you two are dawdling about, my life hangs by a thread. Get to work, slackers! Day 6 and we're already 40% done. Wow, I'm not trying to speedrun this, but I'm doing a great job of it, I guess. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed today in any capacity, please click like. If you didn't, then drop a comment telling me I could make tomorrow so that you would like it. I release new days of Pikmin 2 every Tuesday and Thursday. Oh. And while I do release new episodes every Tuesday and Thursday, you might want to check in on days that aren't Tuesday and Thursday. Because I'm going to be releasing something soon. And let's just say that when I announced that the next Let's Play would be a return to the roots of the channel, I meant that in more ways than one. Pikmin isn't the only return to the roots of the channel I'm doing. There's one more thing. So stay tuned, check in on the channel every couple of days, and I'll see you next time for Pikmin. But maybe it won't be Pikmin. You never know. It could be something else. Alright, I'll stop being mysterious. See you guys tomorrow. Good night. So you might be wondering why I have half a heart left. And the answer may surprise you. Oh, ow. That is time management right there. All right, so Louie is done. And what do I... Wait, what? 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 That works?